Dorothea Dix was an educator and social reformer whose devotion to the welfare of the mentally ill led to widespread international reforms. Dix's reforms focused primarily on the betterment of mental health institutions, improvement of the living conditions of the mentally ill, and restoring the dignity of persons who suffered with mental illness. Dorothea Dix's contributions to improving the lot of the mentally ill greatly influenced the deinstitutionalization movement and proved the massive impact the antebellum reform movements and subsequent progressive era reform movements had a lasting impact on American society. Dorothea Lynn Dix was born on April 4, 1802 in Hamden, Maine to Joseph Dix and Mary Bigelow. At the age of 12, she moved out of her hostile home environment and went to live with her wealthy grandmother in Boston. Dix opened a school for children at the mere age of 14 and worked there for 3 years. Dix subsequently began teaching at a Sunday school at East Cambridge House of Corrections, a woman's prison, where most of the inhabitants were mentally ill or deemed insane. She immediately noticed the appalling conditions and the incredibly inhumane treatment of prisoners, and so she began agitating at once for their improvement. This event changed the course of Dix's life forever. Dix became the face of the 19th century prison reform. Prisons during this time period were damp, unregulated, unhealthy, unsafe, unsanitary, and overcrowded. All kinds of prisoners were held together. Men, women, children, the insane, serious criminals, petty criminals, people awaiting trial. All housed side by side. Dix visited every public and private facility she could access, documenting the conditions she found with unwavering honesty. She then presented her findings to the legislature of Massachusetts, demanding that officials take action toward reform. Her reports, filled with dramatic accounts of prisoners flogged, starved, chained, physically and sexually abused by their keepers, and left naked without heat or sanitation, shocked her audience and galvanized a movement to improve conditions for the imprisoned and insane. Dix went on to Europe. She discovered enormous disparity between public and private hospitals and great differences among countries. She recommended reforms in many countries, and most significant, met with Pope Pius IX, who personally ordered construction of a new hospital for the mentally ill after hearing her report. Dix returned to the United States in 1856. When the Civil War broke out in 1861, she became a volunteer to the nursing corps for the Union and was appointed superintendent of Army nurses. Also during this time period, she worked alongside the likes of Louisa May Alcott and Addie L. Blue. After the war, she briefly returned to her work on behalf of the mentally ill and continued lobbying for her causes. Dorothea Lynn Dix died on July 17, 1887, in Trenton, New Jersey.